Hello, y'all. What's up? So today, I have a lot to do, but I already took Christmas down. No, I already took fall down, and I'm probably going to clean up today. But what are we going to do today? Oh, so right now I have to go to Green Hills and get my ring. It got messed up. And then today, I know it's like, you know, November or whatever, but I'm going to make pasta today, and also gonna make cookies. And since I have to go to Green Hills, it's where I got my ring, whatever, I'm gonna go to Trader Joe's because I don't live close to a Trader Joe's. So I'm gonna go see what Trader Joe's has for Christmas, and then so I'll see you guys when I come back from the jewelry to get my ring. And after I come back from Trader Joe's, we'll come back to the house, we'll chit chat. And I think I want to chit chat in the kitchen while I make my cookies and make dinner for today. All right, I'll see you guys in a little bit. Bye. So these are the prenatal vitamins that I got last time I went to Green Hills. Y'all, please let me know. This year is the first year that I'm really, really getting serious about trying to have a baby. And it's making me very emotional. Like, have you guys had these feelings before you try to have a baby? Like, I'm having all these thoughts. Like, I'm thinking, like, it's just a lot of thoughts. Like, I'm thinking, oh my goodness, I'm gonna be responsible for a whole human being. I'm not gonna be able to live my life anymore. I know that sounds selfish, doesn't it? I also think, like, you know, I just think about things like, I want to recreate a safe environment for my future children. I'm thinking to myself, am I at that level where I can be a really good mother? And I think I can, because I've learned so much. So it's like a lot of pressure, you know, because I keep thinking, like, okay, what habits do I have right now that I need to really make sure I get rid of, you know? And I'm thinking, should I take parenting classes? Should I learn how to talk to children? Should I take, you know, some kind of classes on how to, you know, raise a person? Like, you don't get any classes to learn how to do it. Oh goodness, this is the thoughts that I've had. And then I'll start thinking about things, and I'll start thinking about certain things, and I'll start crying, you know. Oh my goodness, I know, it's a lot. Okay, so this right here is my mango smoothie. So it's frozen mangoes, half and half, apple juice, and Greek yogurt. It's so good. And then I put whipped cream on top. This is my breakfast. I forgot to show you guys the outfit for the day. This is it, jeans. This is like my husband's outfit. My husband picked this outfit out for me. I still can't stop wearing these jeans. I love it. Am I too old to be wearing ripped jeans? Is this unclassy? anyways, so yeah, I got this right here. It's 67 degrees, so I think this is perfect for that. And then I got this top. Where did I get this from? I'm trying to think. It's a place where my husband likes to get clothes. What is it called? Lordy, I'll put it down once I figured out the name. What is it called? It's one of those country places, you know, like those country people kind of clothes, you know. Anyway, so yeah, I got this outfit basically from where my husband likes to get his clothes. They have really good jeans. So, yep. Let me go ahead and go. Okay, so I just had a thought to my head, and I was just thinking about so many things. And, you know, I was thinking about how, you know, I'll talk for myself, but, you know, most people, they want to feel important. They want to feel valued. And, you know, there's a big problem, in my opinion, when you think that you're not important if you don't have this. You think that you're not as valuable if you don't live this kind of way, if you don't have these kind of things. And I want to tell you something that a lot of people really, really, or maybe it was just me a long time ago, I don't know. You're important. You are inherently important. You are inherently valuable. Okay? And so, like there's like something that, you know, somebody in my family said, oh, you're a nurse. Why don't you, like, you know, talk about nurse? It's just not something I feel like talking about, because I've been a nurse for a long time, so it's not that deep, you know? And you know, if they say, if you don't have nothing nice to say, then don't say it. But anyways, I just wanna say that you're inherently worthy. You're inherently important. It doesn't matter what occupation you have. It doesn't matter what education you have. It doesn't matter where you live. It doesn't matter what you have. It doesn't matter, you know, the physical things you do or don't have. What really matters is, you know, are you safe? Are you clothed? Are you fulfilled? Are you happy? You know, are you content? And for me, this is my personal opinion. You know, do you have that strong foundation and connection with God? Because God created you. He created all of us, right? So that means He wanted us to be here. You know, how do you feel about yourself? And I feel like a lot of us, including myself, sometimes we can give our power away by letting other people define what's important and what's not important, you know, and letting other people cast their value on us. And I'm here to say, reminding myself and reminding you that you're already important, that you're already valuable, and that you're already beautiful, that you're already important, you know. And there's just things in our society, I know the way it is, you know, how we get treated depending on certain things, but I'm gonna tell you something. If you know that you're inherently valuable and worthy, nobody can touch you. You know, you feel the most powerful, you feel the most great, and you can have the most peace. And like I said in my other videos, some people have all the things in the world, all the accolades, but they don't feel important, they don't feel valued, or they have to constantly show other people, look at me, you know, give me some value, give me some worth. You're already important, boo-boo. You're already valuable. You're already everything that you need to be, with all your flaws, with all the good things about you, with all the bad things about you, with everything. Because guess what? Everybody has a little good, a little bad, a little this, a little that. Everybody has some kind of problem. You know, we might not blast it out there for the world to see, but you know, we all have our weaknesses, we all have our strengths, and you know, there's always going to be, you know, I hate to say it, there's always going to be somebody smarter than you, there's always going to be somebody better than you, there's always going to be somebody prettier than you, there's always going to be something that somebody is going to be better than you. So why not just look at yourself in the mirror and say, hey girl, you're enough for me, I love you, you know, why not come with that attitude? Anyways, that's all I have to say. Let me go ahead and get this ring. You should let him love you. Let him be the one to give you everything you want and need. Baby, good love and attention. Your true beauty's attention. Looks so good that it hurts. You're a dime plus 99 and it's a shame. Don't even know what you were. Everywhere you go, they stop and stare, cause you bad in the shows. From your head to your toe, out of control, you should let me love you. Let me be the one to give you everything you want and need. Baby, good love and affection. I used to sing that song all the time, honey. And now I got me a man who loves me. Buys me jewelry. Okay, so this is a cookie I'm gonna try and make. I hope it turns out good. And this is the recipe that I'm gonna make. So it's called creamy pumpkin spaghetti with chicken. Oh no, I don't have any olive oil. Lord have mercy. I'll use butter instead. And I don't have chicken. So I got this from Trader Joe's. Since I don't have all the ingredients, like I don't have the chicken broth and I don't have the olive oil, that's really bothering me. So I'm just gonna make this tonight with chicken and then we'll have these cookies. So yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and make this. It says to use this whole thing. Preheat the oven to 350, one large egg, one stick of butter, and 2 tablespoons of water. Let me get the tablespoons. Okay, so we can just chit chat while I do this. Okay. Oh my goodness, you guys, I just met a neighbor. I'm the kind of person who, I don't know, I like having friends and I like being with people, but honestly, to tell the truth, I do like my alone time a lot,
I also enjoy, you know, being by myself. I don't know if I've always been like this, but I'm very different now. But I also, you know, like spending time with people. So I'm very much a loner, but I also love people. Anyway, so I met a neighbor and she asked me if I was a Christian. Can you believe that? I mean, not to say that it's like a bad thing. I've been having people asking me that lately. I don't know why. Anyways, and I said, yes, I am. And she said, oh my goodness, that's good. And she said that she's, you know, praying for people. And then the first question she asked me if I like coffee. And then the second question she asked me if I was a Christian. And I said, I love coffee. You don't have to ask me twice. And yes, I am a Christian. And she said that she was praying for just to have somebody to do Bible study with and just to get closer. And I was like, oh my goodness, that's so sweet. Now, I don't know if I told you guys, but I kind of went to a Bible college or Christian college, and I don't like talking about it too much because honestly, that's where I was like treated the worst in my life. I've never been treated so, I mean, let me take it back. I was treated the worst in my life there, but there was also a lot of amazing professors and a lot of sweet people that I dealt, you know, that I worked with. So I can't like say my whole experience is bad, but there was, you know, just instances that I didn't like. Okay, let me go ahead and mix this up. Let's get the pan. Let's get the pan. Anyways, I did take a Bible class, which actually helped me a lot learn about the New Testament. It was a New Testament, so that was nice. Sorry, y'all, I'm looking for something. I consider myself naturally a good person. It doesn't matter what religion or anything I am. I consider myself just naturally a decent person, you know? So sometimes I wonder, I'm like, God, I have changed so much and I like so much better than I used to be, God. Like, you want more from me? You know, I'm like, what else can I give you, God? And I'm having that thought. I'm like, what else do you want from me? So that is a question that I'm having, you know? I'm like, I mean, what do you want from me? I don't know, maybe that's not a good question to ask, but I do feel like God is like placing people around me, and it's like, oh my goodness, you want me to, what else do you want me to give you, God? I feel like I do a lot already. So yeah, that's what I'm going through. What else can I talk about? Ooh, let's go ahead and show you the dough.
It's actually pretty thick.
So yeah, that's interesting. That is very interesting. I wonder how we're going to do the Bible study. And I think that would be amazing to actually have, like, maybe we can get like a, you know, I can ask some more people to join and it can be just like a sisterhood, you know, like a sisterhood to like do Bible study together. I think that would be nice. And it's crazy because I was praying. I was like, God, I want to have, you know, people in my life push me to be a little bit closer to God. I did ask that. I said, I want people in my life to push me to be closer to God. So maybe that's what that was. I did pray about that. I did say, you know, bring me people in my life who want to have the same walk with God. Like, because I can't do this by myself. You know, I need some sisterhood or some support or like-minded individuals who want to do, you know, similar things to me. Because believe it or not, you know, sometimes it's easy to be influenced in the wrong direction. You know, Faith. Where are you? So I had a video that I made, and I'm not gonna post it yet because I don't know. I just don't wanna. It's hard for me to make a video like that. And basically, the video is saying, you know, to get a college education, and why not get a college education that's like STEM program, which is science, technology, engineering, and math. But you know, just because you have a college degree does not mean that you're, you know, automatically somebody who's smart, or just because you don't have a college degree doesn't mean that you're not, you know, intellectually gifted or smart or anything like that. These are just certifications. When you go to college, it basically means that you can follow some kind of curriculum, you can take a test, you can answer the questions, and you can do it in a way where they feel like that you comprehend enough. That's all it is, you know. And I hate the idea, or I hate it, like, I did not have a college degree for a long time. I got my college degree later. And I remember having the feeling like, oh, I don't have a college degree. And I felt like I was left out. I felt like, this was me. I felt like I wasn't smart enough. I felt like, oh my goodness, that, you know, I can only be smart if I have a college degree. And then I went to college and I realized I'm still the same person. All it does is just, you know, yeah. So everybody doesn't go to college. And just because you didn't go to college doesn't mean that you don't have a lot of skills and qualities. And another thing that makes me kind of nervous about making that, posting that video, is because there's people out there who are just gifted in other things besides something that college would offer, you know? And, you know, there's people who don't need to go to college, but I guess I'm making the video for people who probably want to go to college because they just want to have some guidance or something like that, or they feel like that would be a good way for them to make a way, make a life. And the reason why I posted that video is because I care about you guys, and I care about especially my younger people who are watching, because I really want you guys to have opportunities, you know? And that's the only opportunity I know that helped me get out of my situation. So, you know, that's why I'm encouraging, you know, why not go to college? Because I don't want you guys to suffer. I don't want you guys to be in poverty. I don't want you guys to, you know, not get a job and not get paid. I don't want nothing, you know, like that. And I know that's how it was for me when I didn't have a college degree. It was just so much harder for me, and I couldn't get a good job or whatever. But if you're, you know, but, you know, you might never have to go to college if you become like some kind of business person, or if you become an entrepreneur, or if you get married when you're young and you, you know, focus on family and all that. Everybody's role is important, you know. Everybody's life goal is important. Everybody's role is important. And I have people in my family who don't have a college degree, and they have a beautiful, lovely, good life. So I'm not saying that you can't have those things if you don't have a college degree. You get what I'm saying? But I'm just saying, if you're thinking about going to college and you want to try to give yourself some kind of opportunity, it won't hurt. And, you know, you might be somebody who's good at, like, singing or dancing or whatever. Maybe you should focus on that. I don't ever want to hear people from focusing on their dreams or whatever it is they feel like God put them on the earth to be. Everybody did not come to earth to go to college and get a job, you know? There's people in this world who changed the world that we live in. You might be one of those people who changed the world that we live in. Or you might be the mother of somebody who changes the world that we live in. Or you might be the father of somebody who changes the world that we live in. So it's hard to just give advice like that because, you know, there's just so many avenues and so many ways to have things happen in your life, and it's not just cookie cutter like that, you know what I mean? But you have to understand my background. I'm an immigrant, you know, whether you guys believe it or not, I'm actually an immigrant. So, you know, we're taught, you know, certain things. You gotta go to school, you gotta do this. Okay, so we're gonna put this in the oven. And also, you do have to put into consideration, you know, my race, who I am as a person, and how it's harder for us sometimes, our ethnicity, to get opportunities and stuff like that. We have to be, unfortunately, like, the best. We have to always, you know, do more and have to be, like, so excelling just to get an opportunity from somebody else who doesn't have to work as hard, doesn't have to prove themselves. And so this is the angle, and this is the lifestyle, this is the life that I, this is the angle that I'm at, this is the perspective of my life, you know? But you might not be a person who needs that kind of stuff. But I do have to say, nobody's powerful enough to make you change your life or to change your decisions. Most of the times, you know what you want, you should listen to your intuition, you should follow your life path, your life goal, and there's not like a blueprint that is set for everybody. Everybody has their own blueprint. So you just have to figure out what your blueprint is, you know? So that's all I have to say about that. Now I gotta cook the chicken and let the cookies bake. Let's see how long it says to put it in there. burner for 12 minutes.
12 minutes, starting now.
All right, these are the cookies.
But let me tell you something. We have a responsibility. We have a responsibility to these young women in this room. We got to, tell me. Go ahead. Come on. She needs to go. We're the mother's home. We're straight. Not on your nails done. It's your soul. It's your soul.
Let's see what this tastes like. It's kind of hot, but let's see. It's delicious. So good. So good. See, I watched a video and they said it was horrible, wouldn't feed it to their dog. Shut up. This is sweet. This is so sweet. This is so good.
Explaining every little bump and hump and lump. So you did that. You've been doing that their whole lives.
Yeah, that means so much to me because people always say like, what's your favorite role you've ever played? And I really mean it. My favorite role I've ever played is the one I have in this lifetime as mother and wife. Like that's it. That's everything for me. And I really feel like I'm their ambassadors. Like I'm not here to...
All right, so this is the pasta. Big boy is gonna have the pasta with the chicken and he's gonna put chicken on the side. These cookies, somebody said that they taste earthy. When they said earthy, I was like, yes, I love the taste of earthy things. Amen to that. So this will be my husband's lunch for tomorrow. I took a bite of it right there.
All right, you guys, so this is basically the end of my day. Dinner was delicious. And what was I about to say to you guys? So this weekend, I'm going to put Christmas up. So I'm excited about that. I'm really excited about that. So yeah, this weekend, I'm gonna clean as much as I can. And I already took the fall decorations down. So that's down. And then I'm putting Christmas. Is it this weekend? Hold on. I think this weekend. We'll see. Yeah. Ooh. So this weekend we're going to go to the tree farm. And then we're going to decorate. And then hopefully I can get that posted on the 20th. So yeah, it's a good week. I'm excited. And I was about to say, if you are... I wish I knew who my audience was. I wish I knew, like, you know, are you married? Are you single? Are you middle age? Actually, you know what? I do kind of have an idea who's watching. I kind of have an array of a lot of people. I have different age groups and everything like that. It's a mix. I got a mix going on here. But I never want to say anything that's going to offend anybody. And I also want to say, like, you know, everybody has their different walks of life. Everybody has a way that they want to live their life. Everybody has a way of how they want to manage things. You know your life. You know what works for you. You know what doesn't work for you. You don't need anybody to tell you how to live your life. Like, you can do your research. You can always do your research. And if you know what you got to do for your life, you know what works out for your life. I might be looking at the next president right now, okay? If it's like a younger person, I might be, you know, whatever. Your children might be people who are inventors. You just don't know who you can come in contact with and what your gift is and what your life, you know, will entail. So I can't tell people how to live their life because your life is already mapped out for you, you know? Your life is already mapped out for you. Anything that's happened in your life was supposed to happen. Anything that you imagine or dream of or vision is because, you know, you're supposed to imagine and envision that. So there's no cookie cutter way of telling somebody how to live their life because that's only you. That's only for you to figure out. That's only for you to envision. That's only for you to embody and that's for you to live. All right. Good night. Love ya. Bye.